hanging in the balance. Castle Black loomed larger than ever. Inside, Kutaro must face his mortal enemy, the Moon Bear King. The final battle draws near. It's the beginning of the end, folks.
Yes, the beginning of the end.
Yes, and this is...
Welcome back and stuff. I'm welcoming you back on Mark's game because... Screw it.
And this is the last episode of Puppeteer. Well, I might make one more video showing off the heads and bonus levels we missed. But other than that, this is the last video. So, here we go. And look at all those
you
souls.
You got 30 souls to find. Now and two heads. To Kutaro's tale.
I know, back to Kutaro's tale.
Yay.
Ah, fate. As the forces of light and darkness said Marco... What could the moon say, but Polar? The bitter struggle for power between the shimmering castle Waxwane and the shadowy castle Grizzlestein had reached a healthy boil. Hero and tyrant would soon have their final showdown. At stake were not just one boy's fate, but the fate of the whole moon, and the earth, and the sun, and galaxy, and... Well, let's just say he better not mess up. Now it just so happens, Kutaro and Picarina weren't the only ones who had refused to give up on the White Castle.
A battle be brewing behind! Man the long toms! Raise those mizzen masts! Look alive, me buckos! There be no getting the Davies now! Aim for the Black Castle! Where be my coxswain? Ginyar! Faster! Put you back in it!
He broke his leg!
Hi, hi, Captain.
The buxom beauty Esma Potts has need of her able seamen. Fire! Fire!
Thanks to Kutaro, the White Castle had been restored. And now the stage was set for their epic clash with Castle Grizzlestein.
Here we go.
Stormed the enemy vessel.
You're the pirate.
Ugh, all right, fine, we'll do it.
Bouncing on his leg.
Handsomely now. Trajectory locked. Fire!
Oh, I got it. Oh wait, I can use the castle head. Head action. What have I done?
This.
Head! Okay, well, off we go then. Fire! Whoa, okay. We're taking the high path then. Low path it is!
Half the time, I see these things going in the background, so I don't even know.
None of them have new souls, but take them out anyway.
Oh, I can reverse the direction by hitting that button when it's lit.
Waiting. Now! That looks suspicious.
What?
Whatever.
Gaffhead. Huh. Electric cords.
I see what I gotta do here.
There must be a way out.
Oh. I've gotta combine all my powers!
Except your shield.
Okay.
Go!
Done.
Okay. We're free.
Hooray.
Done. What's up with that shaking? Oh, whatever.
That should stop the electricity.
Here we go. the bigger the gear seems to be. Oh, come on. Where's the castle itself? Not mean to get up there.
That just completely stopped it.
What's the hold up, lad? We can't take much more of this. It's
not ours. Did my head blow up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Go.
Grubs.
Snip, snip. Cut
the
cut.
No new souls. No new souls. I see. Oh no, you don't. Stay on green. Gotta get to the opening.
I can just hit it and keep green forever.
There we go. Okay, waiting for the opening to come up. Ugh.
Kutaro cut his way toward the main shaft. He had to destroy this massive gear and bring the castle to a screeching halt.
As long as I can hit those lights, I'll keep it green.
Down, 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 Kutaro. Yeah, take that. Okay, that's the first time.
But there was no time to celebrate.
Fire!
Don't I have to examine a cannonball after you get launched?
Yeah,
now?
The third time. We've only been launched two times now.
Well, technically, we weren't really launched the first time.
Just to play it safe, feel free to examine as many cannonballs as you want!
Already ahead of you on that one.
Okay.
It took the fire and brimstone sort of fire to keep this castle stoked.
Huh, a grub.
Kutaro jumped over to the cylinders and cut through the belches of smoke.
There we go. Ow! Take that, you jerk. Oh, a grub manufacturing section. Okay, and here we go.
Are those grubs hanging there? Correction, ex-grub?
Huh.
The Black Castle used chunks to transport.
Hold on.
What?
Examine the three. Whoa, wait. Examine those. Got it. I got the grub head. Keep it! I guess I gotta. There it is! Let's go!
You shouldn't have jumped out of that.
Oh, oh! Donkey Kong Country! Do I still have the... Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Okay. Nope. Okay.
I can spin the thingies to get the fire to stop.
Anyway, those aren't new souls, so let's just go!
I couldn't get rid of that for you for some reason.
Run! That thing's coming after us! Speed up!
But I can stop it from moving.
Oh, good. Take that! Now!
Slam!
That thing's gonna shoot at me. Got ya! Got ya, punks!
What's in that?
Hot.
Take that! Okay, it's open again.
You know you could have just thrown a bomb and let me take it, right? He's like, why are you doing it the hard way?
Just to make it look more interesting, I guess.
I mean, who forgets they have a super cheap partner character?
Alright, third time! Get ready to examine the cannonball! Fire!
Where?
When we enter the castle, there should be a cannonball. Yeah, okay, where is it? Here we go, we got it! Ah, I don't think I'm supposed to be here, though. Give me that head! Okay. Am I supposed to go? No? Okay.
I think you can just jump on this.
Okay.
Or maybe not.
What the? Where am I supposed to go?
I don't know.
Snip something, maybe?
Can you jump on the cannonball?
Ow. Oh! Okay. Now I got it. Okay, I need the grub head for the bonus. Okay, and we haven't gotten there yet. I checked. Alright, here we go.
What's this painting on the wall?
Grub head!
Ah. Okay. I gave my head back! Alright, there we go. Grub head, action.
Two.
There we go. That is not the grub head. This is the grub head. Oh my gosh!
It's a super grub! No, a mega grub! Or maybe it's the introduction to the bonus thingy.
Correct! Kunarol, come on down!
Three, two.
Wait,
one.
Some of the grubs in here have souls!
This is it! This is how we get the last of the souls! I didn't know that was going away! Just for the record!
Keep moving or it'll carry you away!
Okay, here I go. So that must be where all those souls are! That bonus level!
No wonder they're able to keep counting us!
No wonder I'm missing so many souls. It's in an area I've never been to before. Okay. Wait for the conveyor belt to get closer and then jump!
Go.
I wonder if I can get those souls by replaying that bonus stage out of the level.
Maybe not. Who knows?
Anyway. Ow! There we go. Wait for that bomb. Or you could just blow off the bomb and I can just move.
Yeah. Isn't that how we've been doing this whole game?
Okay. Gotcha!
Yeah, I'm... By the way, you don't have to use bombs. You just have to pull the thing. I'm getting rid of the bombs that it shoots so that it doesn't hit you.
Done! Wait. Dark castle! I don't have the dark castle!
Go!
On
go.
Me, so let's just go!
That would have given you a shortcut, by the way.
To sneeze away from a massive explosion. Were Kutaro and Picarina going to make it?
Working on it!
Go, go.
Cheat! I mean, it's not cheating anymore, but big cut! Big cut! Snippity, 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 boom!
Between Castle Waxwain's fusillades and Kutero's own efforts, the Black Castle had finally screeched to a halt. Its ramparts ruptured and Bailey's blaze, and the victor's cheering echoed through its dying hall.
Whoa! Hold on! The Moonbear King is still in there! We have to finish him off or the children will never get their souls back!
We got the Moonbear Kings.
So you destroyed my castle. Big deal. Who needs a castle when I am already invincible?
Poor little bear.
You are in no position to pity me. I am all powerful.
And what does that achieve? It won't fill the emptiness in your heart. You have no friends you trust, no family to love, no subjects who love you back. You're still just the lonely little bear you've always been. Power changes nothing.
I don't need love. My subjects, soldiers, and the people of the moon and the children of the earth serve just one purpose. To feed my hunger.
Now, Kutero had done a lot of growing up during his journey, but the tyrant had just one-upped him in a big way. And unfortunately, 'tis mathematically proven that nastiness is directly proportional to body mass.
What?
Who came up with that calculation?
Once General again, Monkey?
The Moonbear King loomed before our hero. His sheer size alone put small mountains to shame.
I'll devour the whole moon! If that's what it takes to get rid of you.
Wait. Oh, I gotta use the bomb! Got ya!
A little.
I broke his. Take that!
Ho ho!
Take that!
Why you? Gotcha! Show yourself, you twerp!
You twerp.
Who are you? A member of Team Rocket?
Yes, yes, yes.
Go!
Go!
Keep snipping! Keep snipping! Keep snipping!
I can get rid of the buttons, by the way. And I can also stop him from trying to swat you.
Got ya! Quick time event! That's a bunch of souls freed!
It's like he keeps trying to attack you, and I'm like, no, no, you're not allowed to hit him. Snip!
Oh, come on. There we go. Let's go.
Clear
What's all that dark stuff coming out of him? Is that from, like, the dark side of the moon?
Maybe. Let's snip!
You're determined not to give spoilers, aren't you?
Come on! Snippity snip!
Go! Be on your toes, or your fingers. X!
The quote-unquote all-powerful tyrant was getting taken apart at the seams by Calibrus. Soul of the
square! Whoa.
Everything I see, I...
Oh, I know what I gotta do here. I gotta get my head. Then, I need to...
Sorry. Please keep...
Take that!
Hey, wasn't that something you did against Tiger?
Yeah, that's how I figured it out. Whoa.
Let me get rid of all this crap so it can't hurt you.
Ha. What? Take that. Whoa! Cut! Ugh, cutting down.
And don't worry about this crap in your path, I got it. Just like usual.
Why you? Now! Now!
Well, we hate you too. Again! Go!
Oh man! I think he's gonna cry!
Square!
He hardly looked like a king at all now.
Got ya! Ow!
Go!
Go!
And high slam!
Got ya!
What are you laughing at? I got rid of everything before it could hit you. Or hit us.
Yeah. My head. Where am I? Oh, there I am. Yeah. Okay.
Where?
Oh, dang it! I was so busy looking for my head, I didn't get a chance to hit him. My head. Okay.
Get ready to move it!
Roll! Something I barely ever do in this game.
What?
Roll.
Oh, I forgot you could do that.
Yeah. Rolly roll.
Mark.
Roll!
Go! High slowly slam!
No!
Go!
Oh. Oh, dang it! No! Take... this!
Got your nose. Go!
Yay! We got a new head! Little Bear!
I didn't even know I could do that.
Whoa! Huh. That was close.
Was that the head that you can't get your first time?
Yep.
The moonstone was shattered. My memories and powers were jumbled, and I was transformed. Captain Gaff, I shall never forget your kind attentions.
Sorry, Timber, the one perfect beauty in this hideous world. Gone! All be darkness! Ah! I'm not done with you yet. I don't need that power.
What are you doing?
What's the meaning of this?
Do you want to be my friend? Really?
You're lying!
Oh.
I will not be mocked if you're really my friend. You can stay here forever.
He broke my head! The head we've gotten collected multiple times through this game!
Get the Black Moonstone from Little Bear. We have to set things right again. Little Bear, that power is too much for you. Give it back!
But without this, I'm nothing. I'd just be me. Would you still be my friend? Powers to the bitter end! Oh, Kutaro!
And so the two moonstones were joined together, light and shadow waxing and waning in balance, the way the night sky always meant them to.
Don't fret, one little head. You have grown to 100 times the boy you used to be. So big is your soul that your old head would hardly fit.
Quite right. Kutaro, how will we stay friends if you're going far, far away?
Hush now, little bear. You have a friendship, and that is a ship that can sail anywhere.
Friendship? Again?
Once tight, always tight.
What?
We'll always be friends, even the goddess.
Really? I must remain impartial.
I suppose she'd rather consort with stuffed animals in her magic castle. Poor thing.
That and
so Kutaro's journey to save the moon came to a grand and joyous conclusion.
No! Hooray!
Come back to me, Esma Potts, flower of the moon. Would that I could pluck you again. Davy Jones, take me. Me world be hellfire.
Most of the party's concerned.
Alas, not one soul made it. Yeah, because they were all hidden in that dang bonus level. And now,
before we do the credits, shouldn't we do the last the perilous
journey of a boy? Guess we'll wait for this guy.
Now meet the many manufacturers of the magical theater's mayhem. Let's give them a big round of applause.
I was gonna say, shouldn't we listen to the last storybook?
Yeah. Is that okay? Anyway, let's go to picture books. The little bear that could.
The little bear that could. Once upon a time, a small and lovable bear lived on the moon. The moon goddess called him Little Bear and loved him very much. Little Bear and his 12 animal friends lived in a shining white castle, and they were all very happy. The goddess said to him, Little Bear, you can play anywhere you want, with anything you like, but promise me you will never, ever touch these moonstones. I promise, was Little Bear's cheerful reply. But one day, when the goddess was away, Ying Yang the cat came up to Little Bear. Meow, goodness. The goddess certainly thinks you are very special. Uh-huh, said Little Bear. I just love her to pieces, and she loves me right back. Ahem, sputtered Ying Yang as he cleared a hairball from his throat. Does she now? Then why won't she permit you to touch the moonstone?
This is all your fault, Ying Yang!
Love shouldn't have any rules. With the moonstones, you could be just as wise as her. You could live forever.
Gee, this doesn't sound familiar in any ways, does it?
One of the two moonstones was white and beautiful and brimmed with eternal life. The other was black and alluring and concealed endless knowledge in its depths. The second moonstone was just too much for Little Bear to resist. Eureka! The light of truth dawned within him.
The goddess has deceived us. The goddess has enslaved us. This is no paradise. It's a cage. And no better. Why? She's no goddess at all. She's just a witch.
Little Bear told all of his friends what he had learned.
You're just a slab of bacon. A ham sandwich in a grand lunchbox. You've been cock-a-doodle-dooed, but I'm too chicken to fight back. You make it rain, but haven't you ever wanted to make it pour? She told you those were happy fangs, and you believed her. Open your eyes, friends. This is revolution.
Little Bear stole Calipers, the goddess's sacred scissors, and fought valiantly against the castle soldiers. When his 12 friends saw Little Bear's gallant struggle, their hearts swelled with courage, and they too joined the battle. The moon goddess returned when she heard about the brouhaha. Her face was filled with compassion and forgiveness.
Little Bear, you made me a promise. Now be a good bear and give the moonstone of the Calibris back.
Never,
cried Little Bear as he slashed Twilight with his new weapon. He tried not to look at him. One more second gazing at his dear, sweet goddess, and he might give in. ask for a hug. We're free from you forever. The other 12 animals ran off after their new leader. Let's make our own kingdom, they said. And with Calibrus, their bright new future, and their happily ever after, we're just a few snips away. The end.
Well, we know how that turned out.
Right.
Okay, now let's watch the credits. Okay, and credits.
Now back to Kutaro's tale.
Kind of.
And now, I am very proud to present the sensational, imaginational, exceptionally winspirational, phantasminational, metrogensational, geobombational, ambisonstrational. Oh, the heck with it. Here's the cast and crew. You decide if it were a stupid adjective.
My head.
Oh. Is there actually stuff to do here?
Nah, I mostly just snip.
Oh, I can control Yin Yang again.
Let's see, Patrick Doyle.
Doyle!
Even more. Kazunobu! Let's see, there's the snake. Kudo. I go Miyazaki. No relation. Seiji. Kita. Fuji. Hi, Reiko Kaiwiguji. Hiko, the Pagan Sheep, Felicia Nuzir, Joe Yame, Koei Kawa, Sho Gimi, Ryusuko Masakuta Yuneda, Yusuku Inoue.
And away we go.
Toshiko Nakai.
I'm not controlling Yin Yang because what is the point?
Hori. Kyo and knows. I knows. They knows.
Kyo knows.
And there's the dragon. Junko Sano. Nayu. Momoko Ikeda. Ah, creepy son.
But not as creepy as the sunglasses son from Mario 3. Can you do the fast snip?
Nope, I guess not. Kyo Sar.
Oh, every time you snip, the credits move a little bit faster.
So like, Donovan Watt, Milo Feige.
Kevin Collins. Martin Pounce? Well, what do they pounce?
Miku Kondo. Eglinton. Miyamoto.
Jesse Kosher.
Jesse Buchamp. Lewis Gray. Paul Padusa.
Lewis D. Gray, man.
Mina. Oh no! Their name is. It's seriously. Oh no!
Oh no! Yeah, every time I think of oh no, I just think of in Sonic Adventure when you're fighting Knuckles, and every time you hit him, he goes oh no.
Yeah, that's funny. Steve Schultz.
Oh no.
Jesse Black. Entel Powell. Jason Ragatz. I was about to read that as Rugrats. Will Cow. Dave Evans.
Ian Jones.
Greg Yip. Jim Newman. Newman!
Michael Play. Mick Piranha?
Don Mesa. Dan Race. Where's the race, Dan? JT Pierce.
What is JT piercing?
I don't know. Alex Belfield.
Ding dong. This Alicia
Beam. Young. Alyssa Hugh. Richard Jones. Kenneth Warren. Mary Carpenter.
Jack Boozer. Brandon Stander.
Boozer. Jack Boozer.
Something Stander.
Mark Adingvigada. Paul Purdy. Oh, Paul is Purdy.
Ronald. No, Paul is not. Mark Stanley.
Mark Stanley. Mariana Lee. Jim Folds. Special thanks. We'd like to thank you, Sony, blah, blah, blah. Special thanks to these people, you know.
Mika Anna's.
Daisuke Saige Sasaki.
Alan Becker.
And a bunch of stuff I don't feel like reading. Japan Studio. Hey, it's Earth! Oh, we live in Japan! I was playing as a Japanese boy the entire time!
Well, wasn't the name Kutaro kind of a dead giveaway?
Yeah. Finn!
Where?
I found it funny they did put Finn at the end of Finding Dory. It's like, fish, come on! And that ends the Phantasmagoria Tale of Kutaro!
Phantasmagoria? That's a very different game.
Yeah.
Very different game.
Thanks for watching. I'll probably put up the missing head guide either before this or after this, or the same day as this. I don't know. Either way, we're done here. See you next time for Sakura Samurai, I think.
Yeah.
Sakura Samurai, bye!
Sakura Samurai, bye!